Hey everybody, James Arnold Taylor here, once again in the home studio. Been doing a lot of varied sessions, a lot of varied ways from the home studio during this time, and wanted to share with you some of the various ways you can mic yourself up for a session. Now, this is not something that you would just voluntarily do. This is something that would be requested by the place that is recording you. But I've been doing a lot of varied ways of recording because there are varied ways that we actually record voices for different types of projects, be it a video game or an animated series or a promo or a commercial or a narration. There's so many different ways to mic an actor. So in my booth, I mic myself very different ways for different projects, and I've been doing a lot of different ones here, and I wanted to share with you some of them. One of the fun ones I just recently came up with is this. Now, this is actually a pair of headphones, and these are everybody always asks what's my headphone of choice. Behr Dynamics, okay, the DT770 Pros. These are the headphones that I use. The thing I like about these is they've got fabric in here, so it doesn't have that black stuff that then comes off and gets all over your face, the vinyl that eventually wears off. They're also, they cover your whole ear and they're full back. They cover, there's no opening for sound to escape and give you feedback on the mic. But they're very comfortable if you're doing a session for say 4 hours, which is not uncommon for a voice actor to do. But here's something that's really unique. So what I did here, I had been doing a session at a studio, professional studio, for a project where they were miking us the way they might mic a mocap or a session where you have actors being boomed or lapel mic'd, but they didn't want the rustle of the clothes and such. And so they mic'd it this way using a little bendy arm, and they put the lavalier mic, there's various types of microphones. This is a lavalier microphone, and it is attached here to this, and this can bend and get closer or farther away from. So if I put this on, you see the mic is there. So it's not right here like you would like a sporting event, you know, where the guys are on there. Yeah, Bob, it looks as though the team is in rare form. I know nothing about sports, so anyways, I'm just, you know, where you might see that. This is different, but here's the benefit of it. See, I can move my head all over the place and not worry about being just in front of the microphone. So they're getting very creative throughout the last few years of how they are recording different forms of voiceover and trying to make it more like they would for a cinematic experience. In a movie, they always hide the mics, but these are the types of mics, these lavalier mics, that they hide in your hair or in your clothes or in your collar or in your glasses, various ways they can hide them. But for a voiceover thing, they don't have to hide it. They can just put it right there. So this I recreated this from what they had done in a studio that I was doing. We were doing some pickup lines and I wanted the dialogue to match. So I recreated what they did with this little bendy arm. And this is actually a light I got from IKEA, and it plugs in to give you a light, but it has a great lightweight bendable arm that I just zip tied to the headphones. That's one way that we've been doing some of these ones that have a more natural sound to them that allow, again, the actor to move freely in the booth while recording. Another way is through these kind of mocap beanies. So this is just a beanie, but if you see here, it's got a lavalier mic on it, just like the other, and it's Velcroed there so it can be moved. And this way, this sits on my head, you know, like a very cool looking little, so I'm styling in my beanie. And this picks up the sound, again, just like in a film. So it's a more natural sound. So if you're doing dialogue for an animated project or a video game project and they want that more natural sound, I've been doing these and setting them up, and it's fun to surprise the engineers and the producers of the project for me to be able to know how they did it in the session before. But now that I'm in my home studio and they don't have the ability to record me at the professional studio there, my studio is a professional setup and I have all the same gear, so I'm able to do it the same way they did it. And it's always fun to kind of surprise them with that, because they know, here's the other thing, when we do a pickup line of dialogue, they know now that it will match a lot better because I'm recording it the same way it was recorded before. And so there's also various other ways of doing it in the booth. So you would have a boom microphone, like the mic I'm actually recording on right now is a 416 boom microphone, because that's what they use in films a lot too. So you might have that in the studio placed just above you, just like it would on a film. If you see the boom guy following the actors around, whenever you see the behind the scenes, that's the same kind of concept. Traditional voiceover for animation or narration or commercials or promos is usually done with a regular condenser mic just right in front of you in the booth, and you're just working it, and you just keep in front of the microphone so you don't go off mic, you don't turn your head too far away. These other techniques are allowing us to be able to record in ways that the actor can move more freely, and it's more as though it's an on-camera experience to capture the dialogue in a more realistic way. I think sometimes people can get very self-conscious in front of a microphone, and that microphone is right in front of them like that, and they're like, oh, okay. I'll use a lightsaber as an example because that's what I have handy. So say if this is your traditional microphone kind of in front of you, and you're talking like that, oh, let's put a windscreen on it to make it really look like a microphone. And so if that's in front of you, you would talk there. You'd want to be about this far away, you see, from the mic. Normally the mic is hanging down and it's on a stand and you don't touch it as the actor and all that. But these other ways of doing it are giving actors the ability to be a little more free in their acting, but it's also for games, like I say, games and animation, it's giving it a more, just a different sound, a different feel. And so I've been recording these different projects in these varied ways, and I've been getting really creative. So I do this to encourage all you other voice actors out there to get creative and to know your microphones. I have a wide variety of microphones here at my studio. There's so many different microphones you can use. Everybody's always going, what's the best mic? It's really personal preference, but it's also what your voice sounds the best on. So you want to make sure that you have a mic that sounds great, a professional mic plugged into a professional equipment. So the way I do it here is my microphone goes straight into my preamp. I've got the Avalon preamp, and I've got my Universal Audio LA610 MK2, which is my favorite. It's a tube amp. The Avalon in 2022 is a beautiful amp as well, and I'll use that to plug in. So my microphones go directly into the preamp, and that goes directly into my audio interface, which is my D to A converter, my digital to analog or analog to digital converter, that goes directly into my computer, which is a Mac Pro, that then feeds right into my Pro Tools for recording. You want to keep that line as clean and clear as possible. You don't want to put a bunch of compression and EQ and limiting on it when you're sending a signal out for a recording session for voiceover. You want to give the engineers on the other end the ability to choose what kind of limiting compression or EQ or effects they put on it. So I send them a flat kind of, you know, low volume signal that they can boost and play with on their own. So thanks so much for watching. Please share the video. Please subscribe to the channel if you have not already. It doesn't cost you anything. I've got hundreds of videos here on the channel, and I hope you would join me and go back through and watch all the other ones. There's tons of ones. Me doing voiceover, talking about Star Wars, talking about Ratchet and Clank, Final Fantasy, positive thinking. We got some cooking videos coming up soon. So I thank you so much for your time. Please share. Please like. No thumbs down. Only thumbs ups. Give me a comment in the comments as well, and I hope you're having a great, safe, and healthy time. May the Force be with you.